half. That's the 11th time in his career he's had a 20-point quarter. Big Shaq, I know you wanted to kind of tell the people what you saw in Westbrook. What do you see when you're watching them play?
Well, you ever play against a team that had a lot of great players, but you got somebody on you that you don't know?
Yeah.
I think you take that personal. You know, a lot of times Russell had the young fella on, and he just going to him, right? Like right now. Like Durant, you not on me. Klay, you not on me. Draymond, you not on me.
Who's y'all going to switch?
Yeah, you're going to switch against me, and he's just playing super aggressive. Always told people, you know, OKC, they started off slow, but they got a lot of veterans that can take over game. Once they get it going, which they are now, they're going to be a dangerous team to play. And guess what? They don't fear Golden State. We don't fear you. Y'all got four. We got three.
Yeah, and
we got three.
I think this is the kind of team that brings the best out of OKC. When they looking at guys like they respect.
Right.
Because I think sometimes it's hard for Westbrook, you know, Paul George and Carmelo to take the floor and really have, you know, the ultimate respect for the team that they playing against.
Right.
When they look at Golden State, they see the team that they want to be, and tonight they're coming out to prove it.
But when you got a team with four guys, not only can play, but can step behind that line and get you back in the game quick, OKC, they must sustain this lead and sustain the energy they're playing. Because Golden State, they coming back.
Now, BD, we've seen you be on that team that upset a number one seed in the playoffs. Nice dunk over AK-47. What up? What up, Carolino? But at the same time, when you see a game like... I just gave Carolino a shout out. I mean, that's body to body. Just saying, what's up? You took the shirt off, showed your breast, everything.
That's my belly.
I mean, my belly. It's in my belly. But when you see this team, because you've been on a team that aren't scared anymore, so if you're Golden State and you look at those turnovers, do you really have to worry about them being that OKC has the heart that you guys had, in which they'll try to upset them when they really don't care who's in front of them?
Well, I think for Golden State, it's just a matter of them just playing tight. You know, you're looking at a lot of short passes in the paint, cross-court passes. They just throwing the ball anywhere. And for a team like this, I think, you know, at times they kind of lose their composure, but they can get their composure at any time. But, you know, just trying to be unselfish against a team like that, that has length, that has, a lot of good defensive players, is ultimately, that lackadaisical passing and lackadaisical effort for Golden State is what has them behind.
And I know, sorry, I know you're going to say this. I know, It's right before the All-Star break, but with OKC playing well now, they're going to try to get that fourth spot. Right now they're in the fifth, 30-24. Minnesota's 34-22. With them playing good now, they're saying, you know what? We need this home court.
They lost to the Lakers last night, Shaq. Okay. You still believe in OKC?
I
mean, when the team, you like teams that stay consistent. You say win the games you're supposed to. Last night they lose to the Lakers.
Because you know why?
Lakers.
With their big three, the other two finally said, okay, I was the man when I was in New York and when I was there, but you the man. Make sure we eat, and then we'll be all right. So they finally, you know, accepted lesser roles, and they play.
And again, the theme
they
of tonight.
For that number four spot.
Everybody eats.
Everybody eats.
That's the theme for
everybody
tonight.
Everybody eats, man.
Even when Chuck ain't here, everybody eats.
Gary Trent in the house.
Everybody
eats. Show him, baby.
Show him,
baby. Show him, baby.